stay focused. That's all any driver can do. There comes a time in every race when a driver is forced to make that one key split-second decision. Take a chance and risk it all. Or play it safe and suffer defeat. Gentlemen, start your engines. Head in the game, head in the game.
Misstep for DreamWorks. This trailer, I feel, does not click for me. But I will say that I was delighted that they used the Drive soundtrack for this trailer, which is kind of funny because everyone felt the Drive trailer misrepresented it and they didn't get what they wanted out of the film. Although in this case, I hope this is misrepresenting the film. I hope that there's a lot more. But the Drive soundtrack is amazing. If you have not, Drive the film, I think, is not everyone's cup of tea, but no one can deny the brilliance of the soundtrack. So if you're ever looking for something to get on iTunes, I think you really can't go wrong with that soundtrack. And if you like this song, now you know where to find it. It's from the Drive soundtrack. But as for the trailer itself, I did think that the racing scenes looked impressive, and I liked that they seemed had an element of danger to them, which is, you know, the car crash, which is unusual for a family animated film. But at the same time, all I could think was, this is such a blatant ripoff of Cars from Pixar. And I know that DreamWorks Animation and Pixar are, you know, very competitive with each other. And you might, you know, I guess someone could argue, well, what, no one could ever make an animated racing movie again? And to that I would say, kinda. I mean, at least not with drawing huge comparisons to Cars. I think they should have found something else. I just think it seems a little bit of bad taste to me, especially since I don't really like what they're doing with it here. I don't think it seems very interesting. I mean, I guess what I'm saying is the action in the racing scenes looked cool, but it seemed very like, it wasn't very emotional. It was devoid of like that connection. So I wasn't too crazy about that aspect of the trailer. But then, how did I know that it was going to get even worse with the snail? I especially think with today's short attention span audience, I don't know how DreamWorks Animation expects them to stay engaged with such a slow character. And I don't even think they're doing a lot with it. So it just seems totally not to work to me. I mean, if someone was like made this trailer and took it to a development meeting and said, should we make a movie for this? I would be like, absolutely not. Or at least I would want, I mean, I think this desperately needs another trailer. I'm just very disappointed in it. And also, the last thing I want to say is Ryan Reynolds. I don't like Ryan Reynolds. I think he's a little bit of a mimbo. I think, you know, he marries for fame. I know he didn't treat Scarlett Johansson very well from what I heard. And I used to really like him on Two Guys, a Girl, and a Pizza Place, but I just feel, I don't know, I really don't like him anymore, and his voice just does not disappear into the movie at all. It's very clearly Ryan Reynolds, and I don't think Ryan Reynolds is like very snail-like either. So the whole thing I just feel is a mess. But what do you think? Does Turbo look cool to you? I mean, do you like the contrast of super fast and super slow? What do you think? And are you eager for more, or do you want to see another trailer to see what happens, or are you already checked out like me? Write your thoughts down below, and as always, thank you for coming to be on the trailer, not just for the latest trailers, but these quick snapshot reviews. Thanks for watching. Bye.